Hello, everyone. That was the Central Jersey Region Audition Suspended CYMBAL excerpt. That's for middle school and junior high school. This has a link at the bottom that if you want to see it as we talk about it, you can follow along, which I recommend. So let's see here. We start in piano. These first two rolls, bars one and two, have three beats of roll tied to a quarter. Make sure you stop on the quarter. You want to start the roll and maintain it static. No crescendo, no diminuendo. One, two, three, four, and. Now there's an accent there, and this is a piano, so an accent is kind of mezzo piano. I just let my arm come up and the weight comes down. Stop on the and of five. Okay, so the roll stops on four, and then we have the and of five. Immediately after that, on the next measure, we repeat what we did, but in forte. So you want to make sure that the judges get a serious difference between piano and forte. Now, I'm going to have to play with wood on the dome in a second. Doesn't say I have to, but you really need some articulation. So I'm incorporating the wood into this accent in bar two on the fifth beat. I try not to put it down too hard because then it gets too bright. And there's a piece of moleskin on this wood. This is a great mallet. It's a teardrop-shaped, large piece of wood. Next to my finger, it's pretty big. It's an old Ludwig double-ended timpani mallet. There used to be hard felt on this side, and then a wooden teardrop shape on this side. It's excellent for suspended cymbal. It gives a full sound plus clarity. I also use it on tom-tom parts. To avoid the brightness, just such a sudden impact, I put one piece of moleskin on here. It still gives me the clarity, but it warms it up just a little bit. If you don't have something like this, if there's none floating around your band room that you can borrow for the audition, the butt end of a drumstick is okay. And I would hold it just the same way. This is Burton grip. So I'm here and I can just push this out of the way and do my stroke like this. All right? Now, I would use the butt end. The tip, too thin, just doesn't sound good. Too wimpy. So anyway, we have that added. What happens is in a concert hall, you're going to have this large ring. And even though I'm stopping the cymbal on the beat four, it's going to be washed over and covered over with the ring. So I add this wooden stick for that. And then I really use it in the next measure for the dome, which is the cup here. The last measure, I kind of sneak in underneath. Some students want to muffle, so you hear the roll start. I kind of prefer to hear it sneak in. On that fourth beat there, I do this kind of a crescendo getting to it. It kind of comes here and up at the end. It's a little crescendo at the beginning, but I save it so it's more effective. You could do a straight line crescendo, which is just fine. I swish it at the end with some extra faster strokes. And then the fifth beat, all the mallets, and I muffle on the end of five, just like that. Very short and precise, so it really contributes to the rhythm there. I use my body here and my arms to muffle. And make sure no sticks hitting the cymbal by accident and no buttons on the shirt so you don't have any scraping sounds. And I roll the sleeve up so the buttons that are there don't touch the cymbal as well. All right, so what am I using? Aside from the teardropped wood mallet with moleskin, this is an old, I think it's called Fundamental Series by Malatec. This name is worn off. It's their old soft vibe mallet, which is the predecessor. The next generation that's out now is their vibe mallet for marching that they use. It's a much bigger head. This is the softer of the set of these old mallets. It's kind of similar to a DS-11. So maybe a Dave Samuels 11 might just sound great on this as well, which I use those on suspended cymbal parts, tom-toms, wood blocks, just about everything, including vibes and marimba. The cymbal's a Sabian 18-inch French. And it's actually from a set of crash cymbals. I have a pair that I use in orchestra all the time. If I'm playing an opera and I have to play some crashes and then move over to play bass, drum, and cymbal, this is my third cymbal. It matches this set so that it sounds like the same pair of cymbals as I'm playing when I switch to bass, drum, and cymbals. I do that with 15, 16, 17, 18. Any bigger than that, I don't get a third cymbal because I'm not going to play bass, drum, and cymbals with 19s or 20s, so that's kind of crazy. So this is the suspended cymbal part. Pay attention to it and really prepare it. This sheet of excerpts for the handheld and the battery instruments, it's ignored by some of the competitors and they don't score very well in this portion. They spend all their time on the snare drum, and this is where you can make up points where you, other people might lose points. Just also, you have a few minutes to set up, and I'm going to put together a setup video to work through all of these excerpts without any change, but you don't want a suspended cymbal that's making more rattling noises than it is cymbal sound in the audition, if you can help it. I know they supply the stand. If you bring in maybe a washer, a felt, some kind of sleeve that you're going to have so that you can fix things quickly. Maybe even just a piece of paper to jam between the cymbal and any, no metal touching metal, right? My cymbal's on one piece of felt down here. It's a Yamaha sleeve, which is the plastic. If you're using an older cymbal, be careful. That sleeve might be too thick for that particular cymbal hole. No felt on top. I don't need it. I never use them. They muffle the cymbal too much. And the cymbal should always move. It should never be tight. Okay? It'll vibrate better. And also, you'll crack the cup eventually if it's very tight and won't be allowed to move. About the rolls, just one more thing. I spread my sticks out on opposite sides of the cymbal. So the cymbal sound projects right away to the audience. You get all the vibrations going around. If you only roll on one side, I don't hear this side start to vibrate until maybe a second after I start, or a second and a half. And these are just on rattan as well, these mallets. So that's pretty much it about the suspended cymbal part. That's CJMEA. If you have any questions, just write me in YouTube and I'll respond. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.